A lot of progress being made by Space Station, but remember, time is an issue for them as well. 15 seconds remain for them to at least start their plant and get it off without an issue. If it pushes them past zero timer, down to 10 now, the play is going to work its way through. They try to smoke it out. Trades are going to come all over the place. The plant is going down from Canadian. Nitro Cell to stop it, but he's too late. He gets the double, but now Bolo is locked in a 1v2 situation. He'll find the first on the ground, but fails to net out the second. Bosco clutches the 1v1 for SSG, and they'll be first to get on the board with the opening round.
So it's 2021, and you want to play Rainbow Six Siege. Why? Well, CSGO sucks. You're tired of Brigitte and Overwatch. And do I even really need to mention Valorant?
Can I get a blast human?
Well, whatever your reason is, you've come to the right place. Siege probably has the steepest learning curve of any FPS out there. Your first few hours are gonna be brutal. Trust me, I was there. But it's okay. That's why I made this guide to give new players a quick crash course on how to play Siege so you can get a better idea of what you're doing and make learning the game just a little bit easier. Plus, a few of my League of Legends friends recently started playing the game and I needed a video to teach them the basics. Because God knows they need it.
That shield's indestructible.
Yeah, no, throw your gadget above the door. Pick it up and pick it up, stand up, and throw it above the door.
I hit you, I'm sorry.
Okay, so how does the game even work? Well, Siege's main game mode is Bomb. It's pretty similar to other FPS. It's straightforward for the most part. Attackers carry a diffuser into a bomb site where they will then plant it and keep it from being disabled by defenders. Defenders pick a bomb site at the start of every round and do everything they can to slow down the attackers. Attackers win the round by either killing all the defenders or planting the diffuser and not letting the defenders disable it. Defenders win the rounds by killing the attackers. Unless the diffuser is already planted, then they will need to also disable the diffuser in order to win the round. Competitive rounds are 3 minutes long, and if the diffuser is planted, then there is a 45 second period for the defenders to disable it. First team to win 4 rounds wins the game, but if the score is tied 3-3, then you enter into a sudden death type overtime, in which you need 5 rounds in order to win the game. Okay, so that's a pretty basic rundown of how the game works, but how do you even go about doing these things? Okay, let's start with the defense. Your number one priority as a defender is to burn time. I know going for the kill can be really tempting sometimes, but you need to learn to control yourself and focus on burning time from the attackers. They're the ones that need to be proactive and push into you. At the start of every round, it's crucial for you to reinforce any of the necessary soft walls. These will typically be the walls that lead directly to the outside of the bomb site. Not reinforcing these walls will make it very easy for the attackers to open and will give them a lot of lines of sight that they can benefit from. What's critically crucial to take into account is that you should not be reinforcing in between the two bomb sites. Having rotations between bomb sites is necessary as a defender as it allows you to move around the map faster to cut off the attackers and escape their lines of sight when they eventually do get that reinforced wall open through their hard breach gadgets. So taking a secondary shotgun or impact grenades as a defender is always a good idea to create rotates when necessary. You wanna next be sure to place down any necessary gadgets or utility like Jaeger ADSs or Maestro cameras, for example. Then you play out the round. Use your cameras and intel to figure out where the attackers are pushing you from, then use your gadgets and gun skill to either slow them down and take them out. Alright, so what about attacking? Well, during the prep phase, you want to be using your drone to spot out which bomb site the defenders will be holding. Once you've spotted it, be sure to put your drone in a safe place where the defenders won't take it out easily. Intel is much more limited on the attacking side, so protecting and making good use of your drones is critical for winning more attacking rounds. Also, try to ping out any defender traps that the defenders may have set up so that your teammates can know where they are. Once the action phase starts, you'll need to start pushing into the bomb site. A hard breacher will be necessary to get any necessary reinforcement walls open, and your entry fragger will need to start pushing into the site. Be sure that as you're moving into the map, you take out any of the default cameras you see, and especially any defenders you see who are roaming. If you're unsure if a room is safe, be sure to drone it out. Each attacker is equipped with 2 drones. one in prep phase and another in their pocket during the action phase. What's also really important is to remember not to drone too much. As an attacker, you've got 3 minutes. You can't be wasting a lot of time droning. When I first started playing the game, this was my biggest issue. I would be on my drone for more than half the round, and by the time I got inside the building, there was barely any time left to do anything. Drone out the necessary rooms, and then get in the building. Every attacking round, you should be looking to plant the diffuser, not kill all the defenders, even though that will also get you a win. If there's too little time left, then yes, you gotta go for the kills. But whenever there's an opportunity to plant, go for it. Not planting the diffuser and going for kills will more often than not throw a bunch of your attacking rounds, so please don't do it. Okay, let's quickly talk about gunplay in Siege. It's slightly different from a couple other games, mostly because there's something called leaning in the game, where you can tilt your character to the left or right, which makes holding angles significantly different to what you would find in other FPS games. And a couple of other things you need to keep in mind here. You can one-shot headshot with any weapon from any distance, excluding, of course, shotguns, which are only good at short distances. This is why this game is very prevalent with spawn peeking, because people like to try and go for that headshot as you spawn. But attackers will typically be taking assault rifles with higher magnification gun scopes, while defenders will typically be equipped with SMGs and shotguns with low magnification scopes. Keeping this in mind, be careful how you take gunfights as a defender, as the attacker typically will have the advantage with the better gun and the better gun scope. But as the defender, your benefit is usually gonna be your positioning, and the fact that it's the attackers who need to be proactive and push into you, which can make them make a lot of mistakes in the moment. As a defender, try to only take gunfights when necessary or when the advantage is in your favor, typically in shorter range. Each operator has their own customizable loadout with different guns, scopes, grips, and charms. Try to mess around with these till you find what best fits you. Now, what's also really unique about Siege is that, unlike most games, virtually all the walls and floors on the map are destructible. This opens up a whole new world of possibility. As you get better at the game, you'll learn how to utilize this to your benefit through things like bullet holes, vertical play, and all that jazz. For now, just keep in mind that when you're near these soft walls, you are not safe. Enemies can use grenades, gadgets, and of course wall bangs to kill you through soft walls. Rainbow Six Siege is a game about intel and strategy, not running and gunning like some other FPS. Now, I'd love to talk to you guys about some more intricate aspects of the game, stuff like the pick and ban phase, what operators to pick for what maps, how to play vertically, all that good stuff. But I honestly feel like if you are just starting out with the game, don't worry about all that stuff just yet. Just play the game, try to get a feel for the operators and the maps, especially the maps. Like, Rainbow Six Siege is a game about map knowledge. It's 90% map knowledge. It's actually crazy. The maps sometimes may feel like maze when you're just starting out, so just try to play them as much as you can and start to get to learn, you know, where all the soft walls are, what's necessary to reinforce, where the bomb sites are, how to drone them out, how to set up flank drones on different stairwells, and this and that. Those other things will be topics for future videos, so stay tuned for all that. But just focus on the basics and play the game, and yeah. Well, alright guys, thank you so much for checking out this beginner Rainbow Six Siege guide. I hope you guys have a better understanding of just how the game works and some good practices you can be using when attacking and defending. I know I didn't go very in-depth into a lot of aspects about the game. I didn't want to be here for a whole hour. This game is very, very complicated. There's so much niche about a lot of different things, but those videos will come in the future. So if you want to check those out, you like this video, subscribe, like, comment, all that good stuff, and I'll see you guys in the next one.